love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome to Mass today, my friends, as we celebrate the feast of the Epiphany of the Lord. It is being manifested to the whole world, epitomized by the coming of the Magi from the East to do him homage. In a way, of course, we bring Christmas to a conclusion at this time. Mass intentions today, Timothy and Jim McCartney family intention, Rose Ann and John Stephen O'Donnell intention, Ryan Lynch intention, to which we add our own personal intentions, whatever these might be. We bring them to the Lord in our Mass as we endeavor to unite ourselves with him in his offering to the Father on our behalf, conscious that we are indeed in the presence of the Lord being with you is very much the message, conscious of our own unworthiness before him, our failures to love, and our need of forgiveness, which always comes to us via the cross of the Lord. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord and our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Thank you. upon this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star. Grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Arise, shine out, Jerusalem, for your light has come. The glory of the Lord is rising on you. Through night still covers the earth, and darkness the peoples. Above you the Lord then rises, and above you his glory appears. The nations come to your light, and kings to your dawning brightness. Lift up your eyes and look around. All are assembling and coming towards you. Your sons from far away, and your daughters being tenderly carried. At this sight, you will grow radiant, your heart throbbing and full. Since the reaches of the sea will flow to you, camels in throngs will cover you, and dromedaries of Midian and Ephah, everyone in Sheba will come, bringing gold and incense, and singing the praise of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
I'll read you from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. You probably heard how I have entrusted the God to the grace he meant for you, and that it was by a revelation that I was given the knowledge of the mystery. This mystery that has now been revealed through the Spirit to his holy apostles and prophets was unknown to any man in past generations. It means that pagans now share the same inheritance, that they are parts of the same body, and that the same promise has been made to them in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us all stand for the gospel of the nation.
Jerusalem from the east. Where is the infant king of the Jews? They asked. We saw his star as it rose and have come to do him homage. When King Herod heard this, he was perturbed, and so was the whole of Jerusalem. He called together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people and inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. At Bethlehem in Judea, they told him, for this is what the prophet wrote. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, you are by no means least among the leaders of Judah. For out of you will come a leader who will shepherd my people, Israel. Then Herod summoned the wise men to see him privately. He asked them the exact date on which the star had appeared, and sent him on to Bethlehem. Go and find out all about the child, he said, and when you have found him, let me know, so that I too may go and do him homage. Having listened to what the king had to say, they set out. And there in front of them was the star they had seen rising. It went forward and halted over the place where the child was. The sight of the star filled them with delight. And going into the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and falling to their knees, they did him homage. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. But they were warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, and returned to their own country by a different way. The Gospel of the Lord. When the Lord Jesus, my friends, was born into this world, not everybody was happy. And one such person was Herod, the puppet king who operated under the wing of the Roman rulers. He felt threatened when he heard that the new king of the Jews had arrived. and he is insistent on seeing the wise men who have come from the east to do him homage. And he tells them that when they encounter him, they are to report back to him. But they never did, because they were warned not to do so, because Herod had sinister motives. He felt threatened. He wanted to get rid of Jesus. Of course, we know the story about the holy innocents, those early martyrs from Bethlehem and round about, who died in the place of Jesus, who died instead of him. Today, my friends, we celebrate the Epiphany, which is the manifestation of the Lord to all peoples, his being revealed to all nations, to all the pagan and Gentile peoples. The word Epiphany means revelation, and it means the Lord being revealed, the God who sent his Son into the world to bless this world with the radiance of his presence, the God who sent his Son into the world as a great gift to the world, the God who became one of us in the person of the Lord Jesus, who continues to be with us. The Lord be with you is very much the message. And he continues to be with us in and through his Spirit. This is the Lord that is manifested to the world at the Feast of the Epiphany. It's a celebration. It's a celebration of light, epitomized by the star. It's a celebration of the good news that God sent his Son into the world as his great gift to us. It's a celebration of the giving and the sharing of gifts. The greatest gift that God has given to us is the gift of his Son, who came into the world, whose coming we celebrate at Christmas, whose manifestation to all nations we celebrate today. We give thanks for this great gift. And that's precisely what we do at Mass. We say thank you to God for everything that he has given to us in life, but above all, for giving us his Son as the Lord and as the Savior. We say thank you to God for that. And we join ours very much with those wise men, those magi, in their search for the Lord and in bringing gifts to him. They brought gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. They paid homage to him. The sight of the star filled them with delight, and they found the Lord and presented their gifts. So what kind of gifts can we present to the Lord? What gifts can we bring to the table of the Lord, so to speak? The great gift we can bring, of course, is the gift of friendship. The Lord wants us to have a friendship with him. He offers us friendship. He wants us to respond in like manner. He wants us to respond in friendship. He is our friend, essentially, the Lord. I call you friends, he says in John's Gospel. And that's what we endeavor to do in response to the commandment of the Lord, to love the Lord and to love our neighbor. We endeavor to live and to love in accordance with that great commandment to love. And we do so through our love, through our prayer, and through our devotion. So that's the gift of being in friendship with God, in being friendship with the Lord. And then there's another gift which is an extension of that, our friendship with others, what we call human friendship. And we know that human friendship is so important in our lives. We also know that human friendship is not always easy. But if we imbibe the good news, and if we understand what the good news is all about, the fact of our reaching out in friendship, means that we will indeed merit great rewards for doing so. We will merit great blessings for reaching out to others in friendship. And then there's the gift of reconciliation. Again, this is not easy. Reconciliation has to do with repairing damaged friendships, with repairing damaged relationships. It's not always easy to love. It's not always easy to forgive. Friendship is not always easy, because all of these things involve some degree of sacrifice, some degree of denial, being able to sacrifice ourselves for the benefit of another. And that's always challenging. Love is not easy. We think it is, but just think about the cross of the Lord. That's always there. It epitomizes how difficult it can be to love. That love always involves pain, it always involves the cross. And the other great gift that we can bring to the table, so to speak, is the gift of peace. The gift of peace. Having celebrated the coming of the Prince of Peace into the world once again. And peace, of course, is so important, particularly in our lives, and particularly at the present time, and in the world at large, at a time when peace has been damaged in so many ways, with all the conflicts and frictions that are apparent to us in the world at the present time. So we continue to beseech the Lord to bestow peace upon our world, upon our communities, upon our families, upon our homes. We want to be instruments of peace in all those areas. And that's very much our prayer at the present time. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. We may feel that our contribution is somewhat insignificant. It may feel like that. But again, if we have an understanding of the good news, if we imbibe the good news, which is all about the love of God for us and how he has sent his Son into the world in order to prove that love, in order to be his great gift to us, if we have an understanding what the good news is all about, then our efforts of peace will bring a great reward. We're very conscious of that great beatitude of the Lord that we find in Matthew's Gospel at the beginning of the Sermon on the Mount. Happy are those who are peacemakers. They shall see God. So we make peacemaking as we begin the new year once again. Let us make peacemaking our objective and our prayer. It's so poignant, so necessary, and so comforting at the present time. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. We stand now as our King.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of the flesh of the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate into the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, his kingdom without your end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one, the Holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess from baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and life and world to come. Amen. We now make our prayer for ourselves, our community, and the world.
that we may be guided by the star of Christ's love, who has come to gather the nations.
That the tribes may be a light shining out in the darkness, and faithful heralds of the Christmas message, so that all may come to experience the love and mercy of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who govern the nations of this world may be guided by the Holy Spirit to be wise in their judgments and honest in all that they do, and banish war, injustice, and oppression. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as we begin a new year, we may be strengthened in our faith. May we, like Mary, the Mother of God, treasure and ponder daily the daily gospel message, and be active in our daily lives as witnesses to your love for all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who serve God through their work with others, those who care for the sick, the dying, and the bereaved, those who work for justice and peace, those who give support to the lonely and troubled, that they, in those whom they serve, may continue to experience your love and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick or sorrowful may have healing and comfort, and may find relief in both body and mind through the mystery of the incarnation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those whose anniversaries occur at this time, and all who have died, may be led to their heavenly home by the bright star of Christ, who has conquered death forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us ask the intercession of Mary, our Mother, as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Heavenly Father, you call us out of darkness into the wonderful light of Christ your Son, the light of the world. Hear our prayers, and as you reveal the coming of your Son by the light of a star, make manifest your kingdom on earth through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Joy through the night.
the Almighty Father. Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, to which are offered now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed, and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift
you.
Up your hearts.
Heart.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as the life of the nations, and when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made him new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
weeks ago, my friend, the cardinal got in touch with us about the situation in the Middle East arising out of the conflict involving Israel and Hamas and the consequent suffering of people in the Holy Land, for which an appeal has come from the Latin Patriarch of Jerusalem. So we are going to have a collection to do our little bit, as requested by the Cardinal, to do our little bit to alleviate the suffering of people in the Holy Land. And that collection will be taken up now and will be sent to Jerusalem to the Latin Patriarch there for the alleviation of suffering of people in the Holy Land.
Thank you all for being at Mass today, my friends, as we celebrate the feast of the Epiphany, which more or less brings the Christmas season to a conclusion. So thank you very much for being here today. Thank you for your response to the Holy Land appeal as well. Have a nice day, a nice week ahead. We'll see you all next week and more. Tomorrow we celebrate the feast of the baptism of the Lord, baptism of the Lord. Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere. We may perceive with clear sight and reveal with true devotion the mystery in which you have bid us to participate. Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And
the blessing of Almighty God descend upon us all today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Glorify the Lord by your life.